Hi, I'm Darren Rose from Genelec, and today at the factory we'll go a bit behind the scenes and talk to some of the people involved in the projects for developing the loud and clear Genelec S360 and 7382. This is the S360. And this is the 7382. Aki, when looking at this speaker, I can see it's not like the cast aluminium speakers that we've been doing. Where does it fit in into the Genelec range?
Well, the main motivation for this design has been to create a new loudspeaker solution for those applications where you need high SPL in professional studios. Now, typically those are TV, cinema, monitoring applications. And now when you consider that today people are increasingly moving to immersive audio, that means that either the speakers have to be much smaller in order to fit close to you, or then you need to extend the distance a little bit to fit more loudspeakers in your vicinity.
Right.
This is a solution for those kind of applications where this has the ability to really send the audio to you over a long distance with high quality, but this can also be used at smaller environments. As you know, we have a full range of monitors in the SAM series, from the very small 8320 up to something like this, and we cover all the typical monitoring ranges.
So Yossi, how do you go about making a loudspeaker that stays a reasonable size but plays so much louder while maintaining clarity?
It is a difficult task. As a professional audio company, we've been always very conscious and cautious about producing enough SPL.
Right.
Because it's important for professional people while working in studios and such. In this case, the challenge was even bigger. So we wanted to have really the SPL that we haven't really reached in this kind of a package and at longer distances.
Right.
So this would allow us to bring this product to another market.
Exactly.
Which is new to us. So we had to do a lot of technical decisions a bit differently than we have done before.
Right. So the appearance of this product is dominated by this quite significant roundings on the edge of the cabinet. Mm. What's the purpose of this?
Well, there's different purpose of these different features. The edge roundings is of course there to minimize diffraction.
Right.
So all the sharp edges, they are really harmful for the sound. So you get reflections from those edges. And based on the computer modeling, we're able to minimize these reflections pretty well by just optimizing the cabinet radius.
Right.
The waveguide design, it is a deep waveguide, as you can see, and as large as it can be.
It's beautifully smooth.
Yes. Well, it must be pretty smooth, and it must also end to the cabinet front very smoothly in order to avoid the diffraction again.
Right.
And of course it needs to be deep so that we have enough directivity in those longer distances where we want to reach the maximum SPL levels that we aim for.
Okay. Where have you hidden the ports?
The ports are actually opening to the bottom of the cabinet. So you can see this isoplate, which is integrated to the cabinet, that lifts the speaker above the surface, so the ports can breathe freely through those openings.
There's plenty of space there on the bottom.
Yes, and the bottom is really nice because it's not crowded, so it's a good place to put the ports, and we can optimize the open area to be as big as possible for the low frequency output, which needs to be a lot in this kind of product.
Yeah.
We want to reach the higher SPL levels that we have done in this kind of a package before.
Well, we're here looking at the speaker. Do you want to tell us what this is here?
Oh yeah, we have different mounting points in the cabinet so that you're able to use all the accessories that we can offer. So you can mount this speaker in different orientation depending on your application.
Right, and that's going to be quite important given some of the immersive and large spaces we're going to be putting these into.
So there's many different accessories that basically allows you to position the speaker as you wish.
Excellent. Let's talk a bit about the electronic and software design of the S360 and the 7382. The S360 electronics package offers the same feature set as our other two-way SAM loudspeakers, and is based on the same true and tested building blocks. So we have a mains input. This connects to a switch mode power supply. Power supply powers Genelec designed semi-discrete Class D amplifiers. One for the tweeter, one for the woofer. Input is through analog input or AES/EBU signal. And of course there's an AES/EBU through connector as well. We have two Genelec network connectors here for connecting to the GLM network. The loudspeaker can be used in standalone mode using the dip switches here. We have some sensitivity adjustment as well with the potentiometer and a familiar on-off push button. Together, this constitutes a very compact package that offers high audio output power with low noise and distortion, and all of the features of AutoCal and GLM for adapting these loudspeakers to their acoustic environment. Like all Genelec products, the S360 and the 7382 are assembled and tested at multiple points in the factory in Iisalmi, Finland. Here, Sami's taking an S360 for its final measurement and acoustic calibration. Like all SAM products, the S360 will calibrate itself. We'll then make final measurements which are stored in our database for future reference. All products are also tested for electrical safety before being packed. What's the maximum listening distance you'd recommend for a product like this?
Well, the maximum listening distance is really only dictated by the dynamic range that you want to be able to deliver.
Right.
So let's take an example. Many cinematic applications require you to work up to 105 dB maximum. And depending on the room reverberation time, this speaker would be able to be placed more than 10 meters away from the listening location.
What about the subwoofer then, the 7382? That's tied to this?
Yes, it is tied to this, and it is part of the package because of the SPL requirement we had.
Right.
So we needed to have an accompanying subwoofer to go with this package. When we talk about the immersive system, you have multiple speakers instead of just two in front, or basically
so
five.
So we need a lot of sound.
Lots of sound, and in the low end, it's produced by that single subwoofer.
Right.
That is a new design which can meet the criteria of high SPL, and we've noticed that the clarity of the low frequencies is really outstanding.
Yeah. Is it so that it's Genelec's loudest ever subwoofer?
Yes, it is, and it is done with the three 15-inch woofers, and that woofer is pretty bad guy. So it's really, really heavy motor, and it really produces clean low frequencies a lot more than we have had before.
Nice.
So that work is really it's been long work with the supplier, but it's really been fruitful as well. So we've been able to bring down the distortion levels a lot in low frequencies.
And we've chosen not to put it in a spiral cabinet this time, but to put it in a squarer box, which presumably is easier to put into a room.
It is easier to put in the room, and in this size package, the spiral is actually quite impossible to make. So instead of spiral, we have made a more conventional port design, with large roundings and flarings in the port, so we're able to get the distortion-free low end through the port as well.
Powering something as powerful as the 7382 subwoofer did require a bit of thought. It is, after all, the most powerful subwoofer that Genelec ever produced. To do this, we've created a new rack-mountable amplifier, the RAM SW. This shares design cues with their RAM XL and RAM L remote amplifier modules that Genelec has with other products, so they look good together in a rack. Inside this remote amplifier, we have switch mode power supplies, 2.5 kilowatts of amplifier power for this subwoofer, and the DSP and control filters to enable us to connect it to the Genelec network for complete use with GLM and AutoCal. This amplifier module includes an LFE input, digital in and through connectors, and two analog inputs and two analog outputs, with connections for the Genelec network and remote LEDs. It's powerful, quiet, low distortion, completely controllable by GLM.
Okay, so let's say I've mounted my
20 something loudspeakers on the brackets, on the ceilings, on the walls. The amplifiers are up there too. What if I want to make an adjustment? Do we have a solution for that?
First of all, I mean, you can easily reach all the speakers through the Genelec loudspeaker manager software. So once you have the control network connected, you can reach all the speakers, all the subwoofers flexibly all the time. Now, you may want to move the amplifiers to an instrument rack because you just simply, maybe you need to keep those in a separate space. Maybe you need them to be cooled particularly well. And with this loudspeaker design, that's very easy to do because you just simply take the amplifier off, drop it into the rack mount kit box, and then it slots into 2U high space in your rack.
Right, and of course that's where the subwoofer amplifier is already.
Yeah, that's a 3U high device and it can be in the same rack. Now this is a natural cooling design, so this means that we want to leave some space at the top and bottom, you know, under and over the amplifier so that natural cooling can take place. Now we recommend that this taking off the amplifier, placing it into the rack mount enclosure is done by somebody who is professionally working with electrical things so right. that they know that they are able to do it in a successful
to ensure
way.
Safety. Genelec's focusing quite carefully now on the immersive market. Now, these systems have been available in research facilities for quite some time now. Now we're seeing a shift to larger systems, different systems. Why is Genelec specifically promoting use in immersive systems now?
Well, there are a couple of reasons for this. First of all, we can see that immersive presentations of audio have really become very popular these days. We have things like Dolby Atmos, Auro 3D, NHK 22.2, formats like this that are using more than one layer of audio reproduction, two or three layers of reproduction channels to create an immersive experience. Right. And these are now, at the moment, increasingly becoming a request in the industry. There are some companies who are streaming audio to homes who basically require that if you are creating software, if you're creating programs for them, audio has to be immersive. And this means that there's a great demand, great need in the industry at the moment to gear up for this new need.
And we talk about object-orientated mixing now, right? Where
yes.
For any object, you the sound field is presented by a single source, not necessarily a phantom image. So what's the effect
we're
of
coming,
that on what we're
we
doing?
Are coming from a world where the audio was channel-based. This, you know, starting from mono, stereo, 5.1 and onwards. What was recorded was the individual channels that are directly feeds to the loudspeakers. Now this is changing, it has already changed, and now we are talking about object-oriented audio, where actually what you record are the different sources of audio that you are should be able to present over your loudspeaker system. In order to have the feeds for your loudspeakers, you have to actually create them in real time whilst you're playing, and this means that you have to have what is called a rendering engine. So you feed your object-oriented audio into the rendering engine and that figures out the necessary feeds for the loudspeakers. This means, and this is actually very important with the new format, that you get additional flexibility because now your loudspeaker layout can be adapted. It can be adapted to the need for the particular playback system. It can be adapted in many ways and your rendering engine can step up and really figure out how to best present the objects over the given playback system.
And this leaves us with a situation where potentially any of those loudspeakers might need to produce a large SPL by itself.
The loudspeaker maximum SPL is mainly determined by its distance to the listening location. And now if you think of a typical room, I mean they are pretty rectangular typically, so some of the loudspeakers end up further away from the listener than others. your ceiling height may determine how high you can place the height layer and so on. So there are different variants that dictate that some loudspeakers can be close to you whilst other ones cannot. And then you have to select a loudspeaker that is able to deal with its distance in order to deliver the sufficient level of audio at the listening location.
Yeah, absolutely. You can't really build a perfect sphere in a rectangle. Well, you listening could, room you if could. You want to put people in there too.
Well, you could, and people are doing this, but I mean, most of the time it's not very convenient.
Practical, yeah. Yes. Okay. All right, hopefully you enjoyed seeing some of the story behind the S360 and the 7382. See you in another video.